If you look up Wi-Fi, the definition is a facility that allows smartphones, computers, and other devices to connect to the internet or communicate wirelessly within a particular area. But there's a lot more to the Wi-Fi story than that. I'm Nick. Welcome to All Our Questions, where I search the internet for questions that we all want answers to, and I answer them. Today's question is, what does Wi-Fi stand for? Well, I'm going to tell you. And we're starting right now. If you ever go into a coffee shop or a restaurant and you say, do you have Wi-Fi? What you're simply meaning is, do you have a wireless internet connection? But according to Phil Bellinger, who's a founding member of the Wi-Fi Alliance, formerly known as the Wireless Ethernet Compatibility Alliance, or WECA for short, Wi-Fi doesn't actually stand for anything. It's not an abbreviation, it's not an acronym, it's not short for anything, it's not some inside joke that they have. It's nothing, they just made it up for the purpose of branding. The Wi-Fi Alliance hired a company called Interbrand, who's responsible for names that you've probably heard of, like Compaq, the Nissan Xterra, Prozac, among other things, to come up with a name and a logo that they could use for branding purposes or for marketing purposes. Off of a list of 10 to 13 names, the Wi-Fi Alliance chose Wi-Fi so they didn't have to use IEEE 802.11b as the name, which was a great call because Wi-Fi is a heck of a lot easier to remember than IEEE 802.11b. They almost ran with the name Trapeze, which if you think about it is kind of odd because if they did, then we would walk into a place and ask, hi, do you have a Trapeze connection? Ah, great. Is it free? Oh, hey, sorry. What's your Trapeze password? Yeah, the password for your Trapeze. Oh, I gotta pay. Oh, I thought you said it was free. Or maybe society would have shortened it to something else, but either way it goes, I think Wi-Fi sounds a lot better than Trapeze anyway. Good choice, guys. Anyways, the story goes something like this. The Wi-Fi Alliance needed to brand their technology, so they called Interbrand. Interbrand presented them with a list of 10 to 13 names, and the Wi-Fi Alliance chose Wi-Fi. The folks at the Wi-Fi Alliance couldn't handle moving forward with a made-up name that didn't have any explanation at all, so they gave it the meaningless tagline of the standard of wireless fidelity. And now everybody's confused. Way to go, guys. After Wi-Fi got a little more mainstream, they dropped the meaningless tagline and left it with a standalone name, Wi-Fi. They expected the whole wireless fidelity thing to just fade away once they dropped the tagline off, but didn't work out the way you thought it was going to, did it, guys? If you ask around, a lot of people, like myself until now, still think that it stands for wireless fidelity. Seriously, you can go ask around and I guarantee somebody is gonna say that it stands for wireless fidelity. So when somebody asks you what Wi-Fi stands for, you can say, nothing. Why does everything gotta stand for something? They probably just made it up. And you will be correct. And you can just sit there and bask in it while they hop on Google and try to prove you wrong. If you have questions you want answered, leave them down in the comments below, or you can send them to me on Twitter or on Facebook and I'll see what I can do. If you enjoyed this video, share it with everybody you know who uses Wi-Fi, which is probably everybody that you know. And if you're not subscribed yet, I upload 2 videos every single week, so make sure to hit the subscribe button on this page so you can get more answers to all our questions. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Excuse me, I can't connect to your Trapeze.